The Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi, has just won national elections yet again. And this is a big day for India, but it's also a big one for Israel. The Israeli Prime Minister Netanyahu is already celebrating the win. And joining me now to discuss the outcome is Davidi Hermelin, the president of the International Center for Public Diplomacy in Israel. Thank you so much for joining us.
Shalom.
All right, so 2017 was a big year. It was the first time that the Indian Prime Minister had ever visited Israel. Now, why is that the case? And what is the relationship between the two countries based on?
It's important to remember that it's also the first time in 30 years that any party in India get the majority twice in national elections. And I think that this is a good sign to the faith the Indian people giving the leadership of Modi. I also think that the mutual mindset of the new central right worldwide in the international politics is the base of the good relationship between Modi and Prime Minister Netanyahu. And we should remember also the Brazilian president. We should remember the new elected prime minister in Australia. And of course, first and foremost, President Trump. In important countries, the public vote for the central right. And the old ideologies of the central left, with all the progressive attitude, is going back. It's too early to say what will happen in the near future. But so far, this alliance of central-right mindset, which means free market, conservatism, anti-progressivism, and not extremist right-wing, but centrist one.
Okay, well, let's talk a little bit more about India specifically. What can Israel benefit from good relations with India? Why is it so important that we see this growing relationship between the two countries?
In India, you have so many people, so many hundreds of millions of people who are seeking to work in Israeli companies. The Israeli technology and the Israeli high tech is always the first port of call of any country which is looking for opportunities of jobs, of technology, of high tech, and so on. So I believe that the importance of developing the dialogue between the two countries is very good to both of the sides, not only to one of them.
Well, you know, India's role is obviously huge in the world economy just because of the massive mm-hmm. population. And so we're obviously going to see how that spills over into Israel. But Israel and India have had big interests in exchanging water technology more specifically. How do you think Israel can help India in that respect?
First and foremost, by technology, because maybe the people and the workers will be in India, but the technology and the management and first and foremost, the experience will come from Israel. According to now, most of the water we drink here in Israel mm-hmm. are function of technology and not of nature.
Right. Water
and
gen
something like that is important for Israel for the future, not only in India, but all around the world. Any analyst will tell you mm-hmm. that the crisis of water, this is the name of the game of the late 21st and the early 22nd century. Mm-hmm. And if we are looking strategically to the future, so again, we see that Prime Minister Netanyahu understood earlier than others what is the best path to walk in.
Now, another main issue of interest between the two countries is in fighting terror and nuclear power. Pakistan specifically has allegedly been working to develop its own nuclear power,
right.
Which poses a threat to not only India, but Israel, of course. How can both countries help each other in that respect?
I think, first of all, moral support in international institutions, sharing professional knowledge about fighting terrorism, and sharing the knowledge of the intelligence itself. Mm-hmm. Because Israel is an empire of intelligence. Someone told me once that we know everything about everywhere. So I don't know if that's true, but for sure the network of terror now is worldwide.
All right. Well, thank you so much for joining us, Davidi. Unfortunately, we have run out of time.
Thank you.
See you next time.